watching this. So this is my first makeup tutorial that I'm actually posting on YouTube. I really wanted to do this because I got a lot of comments on my picture on Instagram where I had this exact same look,
which I will show right here.
I just really wanted to show the people who really liked it and whoever didn't comment and liked it how I did this look. If you want me to do like a more neutral color, then please let me know. This is definitely a more like purple pink kind of look. It doesn't match with like every outfit. And if you want any other kind of tutorial, like foundation tutorials, anything like that, I will be happy to do that. So if you're interested on getting this look, please keep on watching.
So I'm going to start off by putting this really cute turban on my head just to get my hair out of my face. I love this thing so much. It's so cute. I got it in Okinawa. And I already washed my face with my simple moisturizing facial wash. And now I'm going to moisturize my face with the replenishing face moisturizer. Next, to prime my face, I'm going to put on my Smashbox Hydrating Primer and my Smashbox Primer Water as well. These are really great products for if you have really dry skin like me. It's going to make sure that your foundation stays on all day and that it doesn't cling to your dry spots. It's completely optional to use both. I just do because I have both of them, and I usually let that set for a couple minutes. For foundation, I'm going to use my Maybelline Fit Me Foundation, the Dewy and Smooth Finish. This is great for if you have dry skin, just because it's so like wet almost. I use it in 225. Then I'm going to go in with my beloved Beauty Blender that I love so much. And if you're wondering how I clean my Beauty Blender, it is with this amazing Japanese detergent for sponges. This thing was like a dollar, okay? And it's like better than anything I've ever used, like any soap I've got at Sephora. And it's just, oh my god, it's unreal. So I'm just blending in my foundation, making sure I get under my neck and on my hairline. Now that the foundation is done, we are moving on to concealer. So I use the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in 25. This is a great drugstore brand concealer, and I use it for just under my eyes, because my under eyes are like black. So I just do it in like a triangle shape just because that kind of allows it to blend a little bit. And I use the tip of my Beauty Blender to get into those spots. And now onto brows. Now I'd like to apologize in advance for the unevenness of my brows. I know they're uneven. It's because the guy at the salon messed it up, but life goes on and they grow back, right? So I'm using the Anastasia brow kit in brunette, and I'm using the dark shade for my entire eyebrow. I kind of just make a line in the beginning and then just blend that out and just kind of accentuate the the arch and the tail a little bit, and that's about it. Now, to be honest, I kind of forgot to do this, so I'm using my Maybelline Fit Me Pressed Powder in 220 and placing that under my eyes just to set my concealer so it doesn't crease. This is a great powder for if you have dry skin because it's so lightweight. Excuse me. So now on to the important stuff, the eyeshadow. So I'm going to prime my eyes with my Too Faced Shadow Insurance, which is gonna keep my shadow on all day. It ain't gonna go nowhere. So I'm just putting this on both my eyes, making sure that it's really nice and blended. So pretty much all of the brushes I'm going to be using today are from my Sephora brush kit, and the Naked palette is going to be my shadow of choice today. I'm going to start off with the color Virgin, which is a very shimmery champagne color, and I'm going to pat that onto my lid with a shadow brush. This is just going to make all the colors pop and also give that very shimmery effect. Try not to get this color into the crease also. Then I'm going to take Naked on a fluffy blending brush and just place this into my crease. Blend this out really well. It shouldn't be too hard just because this color is almost a light brown nude shade, but blending is key, as I've learned from my favorite beauty guru, Allison Henry. Then on the same fluffy brush, I'm going to take Buck, which is a very warm brown, and I'm going to place it right above my crease. This is going to be our transition shade. So like I said, just try your best to not get this into your crease because we're going to be putting another shade in the crease. Then on one side of the brush that comes with the Naked palette, I'm going to take Toasted, and this is kind of like a dark purple-ish kind of color, and place this on the outer half of my lids. Then on the other side of the same brush, I'm going to be taking Sin, which is a more pink tone than Virgin, and I'm going to be placing this on the inner half of my eye. Now try to blend these two together where they meet, Sin and Toasted, so that the lines are not too harsh. Then on an angled crease brush, I'm going to be taking Hustle, which is like a dark purple gray color, and placing this into the crease. You kind of want to blend this in with the buck that we placed there earlier, which is the transition color, just so that it's blended together and there's no harsh lines. And also try not to get this onto the lid. Then with a fluffy blending brush, I'm just going to blend everything out. It's just really as simple as that. Blending is really, really important so that there are no harsh lines. You just want everything to be blended together. Now, this part is completely optional, but I like to take Dark Horse on a small, dense smudge brush and place it just on the outer V. This is going to darken up the look a little bit and create a more gradient effect on the lids. And of course, I'm going back with my fluffy brush and blending everything together. Then I'm just going back with Sin and Toasted and reapplying them to bring back any colors that were lost during blending. And now the shadow is done. So moving on to eyeliner, I use this Japanese brand called Dolly Wink. I use their black liquid eyeliner. Their tip is so thin and it makes doing wings super, super easy. And I just do a pretty thin line on my eyes and just wing it out. I'm just gonna skip through this because it takes me so long. If you want some kind of eyeliner tutorial, just let me know. So my eyeliner didn't turn out exactly how I wanted it to. The wing was a little long for me, but it's okay. I'm gonna curl my lashes. I curl them twice on each side, just so when I put my falsies on, they will blend into them. So for my lashes, I am using these ones from Sephora. I don't know what they're called because I didn't keep the original packaging, I'm sorry. But I am also using my Duo eyelash adhesive and just placing it onto my lashes with some tweezers. And now the shadow is pretty much done, so I'm just going to highlight my brows with the highlighter that came inside of the brow kit and just place that right underneath the arch. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I kind of forgot to do this also. I'm just taking the concealer that I use under my eyes and I am highlighting the bridge of my nose, my forehead, my Cupid's bow, and my chin. Then after that, I'm just going to set everything with the same Fit Me powder from the beginning and just all over my face and those concealer areas. Then I'm using my Hoola bronzer by Benefit. Oh my god, this is my favorite bronzer because it has such a natural look to it. And I'm just going to take that kabuki brush that it comes with and bronze right under my cheekbones and then also up the temples. Yeah, the temples. I blended out about a million times with this e.l.f. Angled bronzing brush just so it's nice and blended and it's not really harsh. Then on the Naked Flush palette in Naked, I'm going to be taking the blush and applying this right over my bronze and on the apples of my cheeks. I don't think I did this in my picture, but I'm just doing it just to add some dimension to my face. Then for highlight, I'm going to be taking the What's Up by Benefit highlighter and just putting this on the tips of my fingers and applying it on the high points of my face. So right above my cheeks, down the bridge of my nose, on my forehead, Cupid's bow, and chin. Then to lock everything into place, I'm going to take my Smashbox primer water from the beginning and spraying this all over my makeup. And for lips, I didn't really care, so I just put some chapstick and this lip gloss that I got from Urban Outfitters and just put this on just for a little bit of gloss. And that is the final look. Thank you guys so much for watching this. If you went through the whole thing, I really do appreciate it. Thank you. And yeah, just let me know if you redo it or have any questions. Love you guys. Bye.